And good morning to all of you. I am very pleased to be virtually with you, speaking actually as Joao from Brussels, from my place. And after having had the chance to listen to our inspiring speakers who shared with you ideas, strategies, policies, visions, and tools also about vocational excellence, it will be my pleasure to share with you how we could translate that, or we translate that into action in the framework of the Erasmus Plus program. So indeed, the Executive Agency for Education, Audiovisual and Culture is one of the agencies working for the European Commission and trying to implement at their best the EU program, while we manage programs and funding opportunities in education, training and youth under the Erasmus Plus program, but also humanitarian aid, audiovisual, sport within the Erasmus Plus program as well, culture, citizenship, and via survey, via providing data, we also contribute to EU knowledge and expertise. If you click on our website, you will find actually all the funding opportunities that we provide, but also very interesting example of good practice of a project that we are implementing so far in all kinds of subjects. So I really invite you to have a look, to go through this site, and I'm sure that you will find some areas of interest for your project, because we are indeed there as an executive agency to help you grow your project. We are in permanent interaction with our target publics, with our stakeholders, to make sure that those programs are implemented in a very efficient way. We provide quality service, we have transparent and objective procedure, and we try to connect all the European citizens, but also the citizens of the world via all those initiatives, with an important part which is allocated to innovation, to skills, and to all kinds of activities linked to knowledge and ideas that we can share all together, especially in those very specific circumstances. So during the last 7 years, we really had the pleasure to implement Erasmus Plus, which is one of our main activities, but we have also very interesting activities linked to Creative Europe, with culture, with media. We develop projects under Europe for Citizens. When you will receive the slides, you will see that under each block, when you will click on it, you will see a presentation, a synthetic presentation of the goals of those programs, but also what are their target public, what is their budget, what is the way you can achieve interesting projects in presenting activities under those different blocks. But outside of those different programs, we also implement activities in the field of EU aid volunteers, European Solidarity Corps, you can see that on the next slide. And also we have interesting initiatives with dealing with intra-Africa mobility schemes. So this is very interesting for us, and we are developing excellent link also with all of you, all the countries of the world that are so successfully participating into our program. So how do we translate this support that we provide to the beneficiary? Well, in our objective of turning policy into action and result, you can see on the next slide actually what we call the project life cycle. Actually, we support the Commission in designing call for proposal, in designing program guides. Then we are in charge of the project selection together with all kinds of service for the Commission which have an interest in those programs. At the end of the selection process, we implement the grant agreement. We are supporting and coaching projects to implement their project in the best circumstances via different launching and kickoff meetings and launching initiatives via a set of monitoring action to be extremely close to the project in this supportive approach, which is so important for us. We are also there to make sure that the EU grants are spent in an appropriate way. So we have a set of controls and audit measures. And what is very interesting also in the role is at any stage of the project, when we receive information, progress, final report, we try to wrap up what are the trends of the implementation of the project, what are the impact, and how we can feed policy in the sectors concerned by recommendation, by results that were implemented by the project. So you as project partners, as project beneficiary, either currently dealing with a project or intending to deal with a project, you play a very precious and very active role in feeding the policy that we give as a feedback to our commission colleagues to enter into a new cycle. So this is the way we implement our day-to-day work. But to give you an example, which is really at the core part of our interest today, I will explain to you how we translate that into action under the Center of Vocational Excellence Action. Actually, we launched already last year, you will see that on the next few slides, we launched already last year a pilot call. João told you a little bit about already. And this first call was really linked to give the chance to first pilot project, to pioneer project, to implement some activities. We took this opportunity in a very flexible way in integrating this part of our funding opportunity into an existing call, as you can see on the next slide, which was the Sector Skills Alliance call. So for those first pilot projects, we had a sectoral approach to reach the development of sectoral skills ecosystem and to involve in the spirit of local growth and innovation strategy to achieve very concrete goals. So we have selected last year five very interesting initiatives. I will not say you more about this today because we have the chance today to have all those five initiatives with us. They will present to you later in the morning the Brian project that they are just starting to implement it. Actually, the project started relatively recently, very end of last year, beginning of this year for a 2 years period, and the executive agency is following up with a great interest those pioneer projects. But what is going on for the moment? We are actually, as you will see in the next slide, we are finalizing the selection related to the 2020 call for proposal that was for the first time completely dedicated to the Center of Vocational Excellence. We had a budget which was not 1 million, as it was the case last year, but 4 million by project. We intend to support large-scale initiatives for a 4-year project that will really give, with implementing strategic approach, a chance to develop those skills ecosystem at local level, but also to have those innovation strategy not supporting necessarily specific sector, but also having a very transversal view. What is new also and super interesting, except this growing of the call, is the fact that this year we have opened the call to all countries of the world as associated partners that will give an impulse of the project in terms of dissemination of the activities that will be implemented notably. So a few key figures about this call, which is a little bit exemplative also. You will see on the next slide a kind of indicative frame of our call for proposal. Actually, we used to publish those call for proposal in October. So stay tuned. The next call for proposal will be published in October, November at the latest. We used to give at least 3 months, but in general 4 months to our applicant to present a solid application. We have a set of support services to help them. We have help desk, we have info days, which are largely developed and are present in our website. They are web streams. They are also cut in seconds where you can see a specific approach. And we develop a lot of support documents helping you to prepare the best application. So the next project will start in October. We have a 20 million project, so 4 million maximum by project will be granted. We co-finance the project at 80% of their total cost. The EU grant is always part co-financing of the activities. For those of you who wish to present the project, please keep in mind that you have also to inject in the project some co-financing from a national source, from your own source, from the partner sources. Any kind of co-financing is welcome. And we will notify the selection result very soon, actually, already in July, in the next few weeks. The result will be notified to each applicant, but also published on the website of the executive agency. The way we have selected the project was done on the basis of the assessment of three pillars, three activities that are presented on the next slide. The project had to develop actually activities linked to different clusters, let's say, dealing with the teaching and learning. The second cluster was related to cooperation and partnership activities, and the last cluster was dealing with governance and funding. I can tell you already, still respecting the confidentiality of the selection process, of course, that we have received really interesting, very brilliant projects that were assessed on the basis of 4 award criteria that were transparently published in the call for proposal. So we assess the relevance of the project, the link with the policy, but also the innovative component of the project, the regional dimension, the internationalization part, digital skills, green skills, social inclusions, notably. Then we assess the quality of the project design and implementation, methodology. We assess the quality of the project consortium and cooperation arrangement, or the partnerships working or with the work plan divided, what is the expertise of the different partners involved in the project. And finally, we had a specific attention given to the impact, expected impact of the project. What about the exploitation of project results? What about the dissemination issues? And what about the sustainability of the initiative that are presented? Those award criteria, by the way, are applicable to many of our Erasmus Plus action. So this is really for us the point of entrance of assessing in depth what is the intrinsic quality of the application. Just to give you a flavor now about some specific components of the project that have been presented, in the next slide, you will see that actually we have received application which involve more than 800 full partners from 34 countries. So this was an excellent surprise for us. It means also that this initiative is really meeting the expectation from our target public. So thank you very much for all of you who have already participated in these calls. This will help us also in the preparation of the next call to see what are your precise expectations. On top of those 800 full partners, we had also almost 500 associated partners from almost 49 countries. So thank you very much for all of you. I know that there are many countries listening to you today. You will bring a real added value to those initiatives that will be selected. Then you will see also in the next slide that we had a large diversity of organization involved. Huh? The next slide shows that well, all kinds of organization were involved. Vet centers, of course, we are pleased to see that we have a lot of vet centers listening to us also, but SMEs, large enterprise, we have social partners, we have higher education actors. So all those bodies together will build really solid project. But this is the starting of the story because we are already reflecting about what will come next. We are moving forward in preparing already very actively with all our stakeholders the next call for proposal that will be published this autumn. And you will be informed, we will have a lot of dissemination measures. But I can already tell you, and this is how I will close my intervention today, we can go to the last slides, that we are already ready to be at your disposal. The executive agency is there really to support you, to make sure that we translate your allies into actions that are feeding the policy. So your involvement is really transforming the policy in Europe in the best way possible. So together with my great teams, we're at your disposal to give you information, to provide you sort of a coaching approach to prepare your project very well. And I am confident that we will continue to have very exciting project. On our website, you will see also a summary of all projects that have been developed in that field, in other fields so far. But now wishing you all the best in the development of your Center of Vocational Excellence. I would like to give the possibility to my colleagues and to me as well to answer any question you might wish to ask us. Thank you very much for your attention.
Michelle, there were some questions regarding the participation of non-European institutions in European programs. There were different kinds of questions, some of them just regarding the participation and some of them just regarding the type of partners that they can be. So could you say something to that?
With pleasure. Indeed, in the Center of Vocational Excellence in 2019, the participation was open to the so-called program countries. Now, in the 2020 calls already, we have opened the call not only to the program, the Erasmus Plus program countries, but actually to all partner countries of the world. So there is a difference indeed in the implementation and in the involvement in terms of different sort of partners. In our partners, we have the full partners. We will develop the work package, which are linked to the project. They will receive via the beneficiary, the applicant organization, they will receive a part of the action grants, and they will be collectively responsible via a multi-beneficiary grant agreement of the implementation of the action. Then we have the so-called associated partner and countries from the world this year were eligible in our call as associated partner. They can play an active role in the project. In most of the cases, they will intervene as dissemination bodies to transfer knowledge, to transfer expertise, to transfer results. But associated partners do not benefit from the action grant. We are envisaging for the future the possibility to have also partners, country for the world, involved in the project as main partner. Since there are a lot of questions on the type of partner, we have also another type of partner, which is actually the associated partner in terms of entities which are linked to the main full partners. Those entities that are connected to the full partner can also play an active part in the call for proposal in implementing in a flexible way together with the entity they belong to implement smoothly the project. I know that there are many, many questions about eligibility criteria linked to the code. They are smooth and they are quite accessible. And I am at your full disposal out of this meeting also to answer all your questions about this.
Thank you, Michelle.